All right, I want to make an intro to this video. This is I was out digging at a local park and I didn't find a whole lot. Found a lot of trash. I did manage to find a couple decent targets. So if you keep watching, I know it starts out pretty rough and it ends pretty rough, but I did manage to squeak out a target. But trying a new camera, and I thought I hit record on the good find, but it wasn't there, but I did get some pictures of it. So anyway, this video is kind of geared towards people, maybe new people, that this is what you can realistically expect metal detecting, especially if you're digging local parks and stuff. So like I said, not much in the way of good finds, but nothing else. You can see how it detects, you know, the sounds and ID and stuff like that. So hopefully you enjoy it. It's not much to enjoy. Here's the first target. It's in a low conductor zone. Wouldn't imagine this one's real deep. Let me get out the sun ray here. I knew that wasn't going to be a nickel just because on the Sunray Pro, if it hits, might be hard to tell on the audio, but if it hits with a real weak, kind of weak signal and you're having a hard time finding it, then it's, like I said, it's probably just a something thin like a beaver tail. But usually if it's a nickel or something like that, it'll have a real strong, you know, real strong sound and signal and all that. Here's another low conductor, looking not real deep. This one didn't seem too deep. Feel a little bit deeper. Another pull tab, but that's kind of typical out here. So I said, you got to dig these low conductors to find the nickels, the old nickels, and hopefully gold rings. Got another low conductor right beside that one. Maybe it's his brother, maybe it's a nickel. Alright, let's see what we got here. It rained a lot, but this ground's still kind of hard. I think it's real compact. Yep. Identical to that other one. That's what it was. Is another pull tab. We'll get into some better stuff though. I know. I ain't worried about it. Here's one, seems a little bit deeper. Showing pretty deep, bouncing around a little bit. I like these. It's some kind of deep, higher conductor target. Thank you.
gonna dig a deeper plug right off the bat, hoping that it is, you know, like a 8-inch target or so. Maybe. Nothing decent. I wonder if that's it right there. This looks like a piece of a cable of some sort. Might be it. Probably was it. We'll go with that. I don't know if it's copper wire or probably is copper wire, but it looks like it's encased in some plastic.
Got another low conductor.
Fairly shallow, I would think. Right in there. Now that signal, that sounds pretty good. I mean, it doesn't sound real weak. Not saying it's not a pull tab, but a lot of times those beaver tails are, they won't give a very good signal. Oh, geez. I have no idea what that is. I just broke it in half. It's probably some kind of aluminum.
Now here's a real good sound one. Well, probably a shallow quarter.
Sun's just right in the spot where it's throwing shadows. I thought it'd be right on the surface. There it is. Still encrusted in the dirt. That's what it is. Just a clad quarter.
Right over from the clad quarter. Yeah, it looks like copper penny or dime zone.
Not very deep again. I believe that's just a clad dime. I'll see how the close-up works on this camera. I haven't tried it out or anything. Let me zoom in and see if it does any good. Might take a minute to focus.
There's another shallow one in the dime or copper penny area.
Shallow, a couple inch down. Look at that. Can you see it? Yeah, that's another clad dime.
Here's something around the zinc penny zone. Yeah, it could be screw cap. Man, now it's staying down around 30. Let's see what a 30 is.
I Okay, so it's a little bit deeper. It's right in the center of the hole, it should be. This happened to be a square tab. Boy, hitting 30 is kind of high for that, but oh well. Here's a little bit deeper. Seems a little deeper. I'll just dig a little bit of a plug here and assume that it's right. Oh, I think I'm hitting something. Yeah. I believe that's a big old piece of copper wire. Wow, I just ain't having much luck today, am I? It'll get better. Another low conductor. One of these is bound to be a nickel. This seems a little weak. Like it ain't hitting real strong. Maybe a beaver tail or something. Might be too deep. Maybe that's why it's hitting weaker. It's a bit deeper. I mean, it can't be a beaver tail, but. Yeah, that's pretty good depth. I think that's a piece of a, maybe it's not a beaver tail. Yeah, it is. It's a, not a beaver tail, I mean a square tab. I thought for a minute it was a smashed ring or something, but let me see if I can bend it out a little bit.
Well, for another low conductor, I guess I'm a sucker for punishment.
Deeper apparently.
Got another low conductor, but you know if I don't dig this, it'll be a shield nickel or something, right? Then I'll just have to tell you about it. You'll be like, yeah, right.
If I do dig it, it'll be a piece of can slaw or a full tail. Okay, a little bit deeper. It's not a good sign. Tiny little folded up beaver tail.
All right, at least I got a high conductor this time. Gotta be a shallow copper or dime.
Thank you. brought my screwdriver with me. Bit deeper than I thought, a couple inches. There it is. The old copper penny. What the date on that is, 80 something maybe.
Another low conductor zone.
Not very good. Probably a waste of time on this one too, but never know. Gotta dig it. Sound a little bit better. As I get deeper. Uh-oh. I think I see it. Dang it, another pull tab. Okay, after all that misery and torture, just kidding, digging all that junk, I finally got one here that sounds like it has some good potential. It's real deep, staying up in the, I like the way it's staying in the 46, 45. This one has some good potential. I'm hoping it's just not a deep copper. This looks good. Man, what stinks is I just got this camera and I just dug out that deep barber dime, but it wasn't recording. Man, I gotta make sure of that this time. Here's a deeper nickel signal. Maybe after that barber, our luck will change. Start hitting coins. But that's how it is out here. You might dig a ton of trash and then finally get that one coin. But no, you don't have to dig those iffy signals, but how else are you gonna find some good stuff, you know? This is junk, I already see it. Another beaver tail. There's another one trying to look like it's a real deep one. This is more in the lower conductor range, but hopefully it's in the Indian head range. Very good, we're gonna take it out. Make sure I'm recording, okay. This could be smaller or deeper. Ah, come on. As you can see, it's a piece of copper wire. Okay, if you suffered through that first half of the video, come out here to another spot. I got the CZ3D, and it's a tom tune. Not an 1121, but it don't matter. It still goes deep, and it's accurate. Come out here to another spot. We're going to dig some targets with the CZ. Who knows? Might do better, might do worse. Don't know. If it wasn't for that barber dime salvaging that hunt, that would have been, I probably would have went home. Anyway, kind of motivated me to keep going. All right, I got the CZ, and we'll see how it does. All right, here we go with the CZ, the first target.
just something repeatable in the coin zone.
All right, Mel has some better luck with the CZ. Be hard to top that barber dime, but you know, in the midst of 20 pull tabs. Ah, missed camera malfunction. Wanted to flip over on me. Let's try that. All right, we got something down there. Man, what's the problem here? You see, the detector wants to flip over. I guess this mount's too heavy for it. That big 10.5-inch coil can't stop it, I guess. Really? I feel it. It feels like a piece of wire. Oh, come on. I dug some of this at the other place, and heck, I'm a quarter mile away from it. Oh, well. I'm not starting out too good. I think it'll get better, though. Here's the next one. I want to dig this one just because it's in the relic zone. Just to see what it is. Here's that relic zone. Had a little hit right there, so. The relic zone is kind of like in between coins and junk. That's how I kind of look at it. Like right below Indian, but above pull tab. I guess that would mean it'd be square tab zone. Here's the next one. This is hitting something in the coin zone. When it hits in that zone, it could be anything from like a Indian head penny, a screw cap, all the way up to a half dollar, whatever. So you just kind of got to dig. You're going to get a surprise that way. You just never know. But the CZ is so accurate that, you know, it's real accurate. Yeah, dig less junk with it than with anything. Even the Etrac, believe it or not. Down there a little bit deeper. Pretty deep here, maybe 6-inch mark. Still down there. I got it out of the hole. Uh-oh, lost it. I keep flipping it back in the hole. That looks like, oh man. Thought it was a piece of lead right there. No, you gotta be kidding me. Okay, that did I mention that sometimes it'll false on iron. But I'm not giving up thinking that's it, because a lot of times I've dug targets with iron in the hole. So we're gonna keep looking. Yeah, there you go. That's what I'm talking about right there. That kind of looks like silver. Let me see what it does on a coil. It hit in the foil range. But like I said, it looks like it could be wrong, but it looks like kind of a small piece of silver. But let's keep looking. Suppose we got something a little deeper. Like I said, I would believe it. I'm gonna cover it and go back over the hole and see if there's anything better target. I'll film that. All right, I covered the hole. I'm gonna go back over the hole. Still getting a high tone, even though I dug out that rusty bolt and that what looked like a little tiny piece of silver. Still getting a high tone hit. Let's try to find it. Okay, I could have possibly dug a little bit too deep before, so let's dig. I'm still getting a high tone. There you go. After digging that trash. Right here. Oh man, check that out. There's a wheat penny that was in the mix. That is awesome. And I mean, so I said the CZs, they are just awesome. There's a wheat penny that was in there. Wow, I know it was masked. That's probably why it's still here. I got one here that seems like it's a real deep target. Jumping around from nickel to high tone to pull tab. But because it appears to be so deep, I'm gonna dig it. This could turn out to be just junk or something, you know, a little tiny target, but out here in these public areas where it gets pounded by people, this is how you find the good stuff, by digging these iffy ones. And you find a lot of trash too, but you know, that's how it goes. Usually if you get a hit shallow, you know it was just something small. So if you don't get a hit shallow, go on down to about the 6 or 7 inch mark. And then check again. This one was on the CZ was super faint. So if it was a coin size target, I would suspect it to be in the, like the 9 to 10 inch range. So I'll just dig on down, see what we come up with. If I dig too deep, then I'll just pick up the detector and go over the hole again and see if I see where that target's at. If it's in the hole or in the plug or in the dirt. But this to act like it was like a real deep target. Okay. I'm hitting it at about 9 inches, so this is 9 inches, so if I stick that down in the hole, it's pretty close to 9 inch mark, and I'm just now hitting it. So we'll dig it out. That's usually a good sign. Don't mean it can be a good target, but you know, it was a deeper one anyway. Let's see what we got now. Did a lot better hit. Pin pointer is almost buried, or it is buried, so we'll keep going. Getting down there pretty deep now, but it's still in the hole. Let me get all the loose dirt out of there. I'm about 2 inches below the pinpointer, so whatever it is, it's that deep. It's at least 10 to 11 inches deep. But it was coming in real faint on the CZ, which I hope that ain't rust. Kind of looked like it. Oh no, could be a rusty item. Oh. That's how it goes though. Sometimes on the CZs or any detector, is a rusty nut, but it was, my gosh, it was probably 13 inches deep. I don't want to exaggerate. This is 8. This is another 7 probably. So look at that. That thing's almost buried in the ground. So it was probably got out like 13 inches, at least 12, rusty nut.
All right, here's one that sounds a little bit shallower. Coming in at a high tone. It sounds shallow. It's about 4 inches.
It's claimed about 4 inches deep. Can't hit it, so it's probably pretty accurate. Right, we got a hit down there. A little bit deeper than 4 probably. It's down there a little bit. Probably working on the 7-inch range. It was a nice repeatable high tone. I wouldn't think it was falsing on a nail. What in the world is that? That's weird. This don't even look like, this really don't even look like metal. But it's kind of weird looking. Okay, we're down deeper. It makes me think it's probably junk now. No, it's gotta be, it's probably junk. It's down there awful deep. Makes me think it's a bigger junk target. There's a rusty piece of, I don't know what it is, just a piece of a nail or what, but I can't see that making that good repeatable signal. So let's keep lugging. There's more down there. Maybe the rest of the nail. I mean, it's a big old nail that could be doing that. Maybe that silver coin mixed in with the iron. Not in that scoop. Okay. I can see that big old rusty bolt doing it. That's probably what it was. Big rusty bolt.
Got one in the high tone zone.
just gotta find it again. Right in the middle of some trash. All right, we're about due for a coin, ain't we? Dug some trash. This, I think, was a little shallower. Maybe. Yeah, a little bit deeper, I guess. I thought it sounded like it was right on the surface. That could be screw cap sounding off loud. That's funny. Someone put two pull tabs together. I don't see how that would be sounding off as a high coin, but let's recheck the hole. That's kind of weird. I don't know how they what they were doing, but let's recheck it. Now I'm getting another hit. The CZ usually, I don't think, will call a couple pull tabs as a coin. It's usually a lot more accurate than that. All right, we're gonna cover it up and go back over it just to make sure. All right, going back over that same plug. I'm getting a bunch more pull tab signals. So it may have been like four or five pull tabs in there. Just all of them combined, hit as a high tone. Here's the next one. Kind of bounced around, but seems like it's deeper. So we'll dig this one. You'll be surprised on this one, huh? Okay, we're getting a hit. That's a good thing. All right, down there and the plug, the hole. Oh, is that it? What in the world is that? I don't know what that is. It's some kind of, see, it's a button. It looks like it's got rubber on it. Looks like one of those screws, or the washers that go on one of those screws that they screw into metal buildings, almost like one on the side. Probably it. Yep, that was probably it. Junk. Here's another one trying to hit in the coins area. Kind of jumping back and forth between relic and coin. Kind of expecting junk on this one, but you never know. Still down there. I believe that is a genuine Cann's law. But I'll check just in case something else down there.
That looks like that was it.
Here's something in the high tone zone. Sounds a little deeper. Eh, 4 to 5 inch range.
All right, 4 to 5 it said, a little over 4. We'll go down about 4. All right. All right, another big old square tab. I know these big square ones, they hit right about where maybe an Indian head would, so not that big a deal.
Right here I'm getting a nickel signal, but it seems like it's a little deeper. You probably can't tell on the camera, but I can hear that the sound is a little fainter. Let's go to pinpoint. See, it says about 6 inches.
Let's dig out this signal that hit as a nickel. You know, about due for a buffalo, right? Let's see if we can get one. All right, still down in the hole. In this clump. Ah, so much for the buffalo. It's a stupid beaver tail. But these things hit right where nickels, like deeper, older nickels hit, so you gotta dig them.
All right, just dug that beaver tail. Got another real faint nickel signal. You know what? I'm going to turn 90 degrees because a lot of times if you turn 90 degrees, if it's a beaver tail, it won't have such a, you know, quite a as good a hit. This ain't bad though. Both ways is jumping from nickel to foil.
Oh, let's see what we got now. Jumping from nickel to foil. And there's the beaver tail.